This is Vidisha, and today I am going to talk about tryptophan opening. We know that protein synthesis required lot of amino acids, and there are 20 amino acids available. E. coli has all of the enzymes for making all amino acids. Now, these enzymes for synthesis of amino acids are cluster of genes present in an operon. Based on the supply of amino acid, an operon can be expressed or repressed. Suppose if an amino acid is inadequate, an operon will be expressed, and if it is abundant, the operon will be repressed. Tryptophan operon has 5 genes for the enzymes required to convert carismate to tryptophan. The mRNA from the tryptophan operon has a half-life of only about 3 minutes, allowing cell to respond rapidly to changing needs of this amino acid. Here you see that when tryptophan is present at high level, it binds to the repressor, allowing the change in the conformation that leads to the binding of tryptophan repressor complex to the operator. Thus, the mRNA is attenuated mRNA, which is synthesized from the operon. When repressor is not there, transcription of tryptophan operon will happen. So the rate of transcription is fine-tuned to cellular tryptophan requirements by a second method called transcription attenuation. Transcription is initiated normally in this case, but abruptly halted before operon genes are transcribed. The frequency with which transcription is attenuated is regulated by the level of tryptophan and relies on the very close coupling of transcription and translation in bacteria. Coming to the mechanism of tryptophan operon. The signal of attenuation is encoded in the 4 regions in this mRNA. So this is 162 nucleotide leader region at the 5' end of the mRNA, preceding the initiation codon of the first gene. You can see that this is a 162 nucleotide leader region. This is the first initiation codon of the first gene. And note here that there are 2 tryptophan codon in this leader peptide region. And there are regions like 1, 2, 3 and 4. When region 3 and 4 form base pair, you see that there is a GC-rich stem loop followed by U residues. Stem loop acts as transcription terminator. Region 2 and region 3 also can form base pair, but attenuated structure is not formed in this case. And when region 2 and 3 does base pair formation, there is no obstruction in the transcription. Let's see what happens when tryptophan levels are high. When tryptophan levels are high, tryptophan tRNA levels are also high. Thus, this region, if you see in the leader peptide, are the 2 tryptophan codon. When tryptophan tRNA level is high, the ribosome will quickly translate region 1 and block region 2. Thus, region 2 is not available to base pair with region 3. This allows region 3 and 4 to form a base pair, which forms the transcription termination. Thus, when tryptophan levels are high, this causes termination of the transcription. When tryptophan levels are low, there is low tryptophan tRNA available. If there is low level of tryptophan tRNA, ribosome gets halted at region 1. Thus, region 2 is free to base pair with region 3. This 2-3 base pair formation does not allow region 3 and 4 to form base pair. Now, transcription can happen and tryptophan operon can get transcribed. Thank you for watching this.